Now that we know how to write a serverless function, let's integrate it with a third-party API. We'll be using the Poke API, which will allow you to get all kinds of information about the Pokemon world. Jumping into our code editor, let's create a new endpoint for our application called Pokedex. So we'll need to name the file pokedex.js. Then let's go ahead and fill out the serverless function with the three basic parts. We have our exports.handler, which we assign to an async function. We'll go ahead and define the API URL under the constant poke_API. Now that we have the URL, we can go ahead and await what we fetch from that API and assign that to a constant of response. Then I'll use a new syntax here where rather than using the dot then, we'll go ahead and create a constant called data, which will await the response that we'll JSONify using the .json method. Finally, we'll make sure to return an object, just as we expect from every serverless function, where in this case we'll have a status code of 200, and the body, which will contain our data, which we need to convert to a string by using json.stringify. Inside of our index.html file, we'll need to go ahead and create a new button, and this time we'll give it an ID of fetch Pokedex button, and we'll give it a label of fetch Pokedex. And we'll go ahead and add that element selector inside of our JavaScript by assigning it to a constant of fetch Pokemon button. And then we'll add a click event to our fetch Pokedex button. Inside of our click event, we'll go ahead and create a constant of response where we will await a fetch from our serverless function call, which we'll call at /.netlify/functions/Pokedex. Then we'll make sure to go ahead and turn that into a JSON object by using .json, and then we'll make sure to update our p tags inner text so that it'll actually show the response by using json.stringify on the response. Now, when we run ntl dev, you'll see that it spins up our server, and we see both of our buttons. We'll go ahead and open the network tab, but when we click this time, you'll notice that we're getting an error. What's going on? When we click inside here, we'll see that there's a reference error. To get a detailed look at the error, though, let's switch over to our terminal. Inside of our terminal, we can see the full details of our error. Looking at this message, we'll see that the error is that fetch is not defined. You might be wondering, why is this the case? And the reason is because the serverless function is running on a Node.js server. In other words, it doesn't have access to the native fetch API that's provided inside of the browser. As a result, we'll need to install our own dependency. The way we do this is by creating an npm project inside of our site. We do this by running the command npm init. For the configuration part, I'll basically leave everything as default by just hitting enter on everything. I'll go ahead and add my author name here though, and just say Ben Hong, and switch out the license to MIT. But otherwise, just following the default. And you'll see now that a couple things have been created as a result. The main difference we see here is that we now have this package.json file, which is a file that's responsible for keeping track of our dependencies and some basic details about our project. Now that we have this, let's go ahead and install a fetch library for our Node server to use. We'll do this by running npm install --save-dev node-fetch. And you'll see, once I run this command, inside of our package.json, we now have the node-fetch library added as a dev dependency. Now that that's installed, let's go ahead and tell pokedex.js that it's time to use this fetch library. And we do that by creating a constant of fetch and use the required syntax in order to include our node-fetch library. Once we do that, we can go ahead and start up our server again by running ntl dev. And once we click on fetch Pokedex, everything works exactly as we expect.